For the third time this summer, someone has died at Halona Blowhole. We had live reports this morning on the search for and later discovery of the man's body. This afternoon, the victim was identified as Tajhee Williams of New York. Officials tell us the 19-year-old was swept off the rocks near Halona Blowhole last evening. It's a situation rescuers see all too often.
Please heed to the warning signs at the lookouts. Do not go past the lookout signs. The signs are there for a purpose, and unfortunately, this is one of the proven points of tragic that can happen.
Despite the warning signs, people continue to get too close to danger. So what more can be done? Bridget Namata goes beyond the headlines to find out. Bridget?
Hi, Joe. Ocean Safety tells me you can access Halona Blowhole from two different places, and it's partly why it sees so many rescues in that area.
Fewer spots on the island are more dangerous than the blowhole.
There are very clear signs posted at the top of the Halona Blowhole lookout warning folks not to go beyond this point. But take a peek over and you'll see the signs are being ignored.
Ocean Safety tells me people can reach the blowhole from these two different points, one from Sandy's and the other from Eternity Beach. I checked and didn't see any danger signs at each access point.
Yeah. How did you make it down there?
I went around the other way, where there seems to be a pathway, watched other people go down, so.
Yeah. Did you notice that there were signs warning about the dangers not to go beyond the point?
We weren't sure, to be honest, if that meant that beach down there, because when you look down there, there's lots of people. There's like 20, 30 people down there having a good time suntanning, so it's hard to know. It doesn't say no beach access or anything, just says be careful, don't go over the ledge. So yeah, it's a little confusing.
Ocean Safety says it's done 420 rescues in this area so far this year. There have been 6 deaths in the last 12 months in the area from Sandy Beach and Halona Blowhole to Hanauma Bay.
We report on this over and over and over again. What can be done?
To me, it's all about educating the public about the dangers. And if they're educated of the dangers, it's their decision if they want to heed those warnings or not.
The city tells me it added 2 more signs 5 months ago. But that was at the top of the lookout. As for adding signs on either side of the blowhole, I'm told the city will look into it, but right now, there are no plans to add more.
Now, the city says one thing they don't want to do is litter the beaches with signs. Bridget Namata, KH1 2 News.